Hi, I'm Vic Iyer, CIO Marketing Services. CIOs must be a fulcrum for strategic digital innovation if enterprises are to maximize their potential in a dynamic yet unpredictable economy. Foundry research shows that most CIOs, more than 80%, are more innovation-focused and playing a changemaker role in their organizations. Over the next 1 to 3 years, more than half think they will essentially be business strategists, primarily tasked with ensuring their organizations are ready for the future. All of this is vital as businesses chase AI success. CIOs are again leading efforts to develop AI plans, and they must orchestrate across business lines to ensure coherence and demonstrable results. In this CIO webcast with AMD, we'll discuss exactly what IT leaders and similar must do to ensure they're at the heart of their organization's AI transformation. We'll be speaking with AMD's Rahul Tikoo, but before we start, let's find out a little bit more about Rahul. It's great to be with you, but just tell us a little bit about yourself, and great to have you on this webcast.
Thank you. It's really great to be here too. My name is Rahul Tikoo, and I'm the Senior Vice President and General Manager for the Client Business at AMD. This is where I'm responsible for the strategy, long-term product development, and business operations of our client business at AMD.
Great to be speaking with you. Perhaps we could start by telling us a little bit more about AMD, because the company has enjoyed some incredible recent success, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's incredible. We've been in the semiconductor industry for almost 56 years. This, by the way, is my second tour through AMD. I've been collectively working at AMD for about 12 years now. In the last 10 years, AMD has grown to be a Fortune 200 company, 181 to be exact. And we're a leader in the semiconductor industry, as you all know. We're trusted by the enterprises everywhere in the industry, and we provide end-to-end portfolio to our enterprises, all the way from cloud to the endpoint. We work with companies of all sizes. When you think about cloud service providers, Amazon Web Services, Oracle, Meta, Microsoft Azure, these are some of the cloud CSPs that we work with. We've also shipped over 100 million plus commercial PCs to these enterprises. You know, so when you think about that, we're a partner of choice for many Fortune 500 companies. More recently, CVS Health, Morgan Stanley, Caterpillar. These are some of the examples of the companies that we work with.
Really, really interesting time at AMD. And I'd like to start this discussion by talking about the role of the CIO. It's changing, really, as the global economy digitizes. What are your thoughts on how the position of the CIO is changing?
You know, if you kind of take a step back for a little bit, you know, the modern workplace, we're undergoing this most fundamental transformational shift, you know, since the advent of the internet, wireless, et cetera. AI is emerging as this driving force that is redefining productivity, security, enterprise IT management. And, you know, this foundational shift is really, really about how CIOs as business leaders are leveraging AI and creating a much more efficient and agile organization. So when you think about that, CIOs are increasingly being looked at as digital transformation leaders in a corporation. And like I said, the biggest digital transformation that we're going through right now is all about AI and how that's transforming the company. And you as a CIO have to embrace it. You cannot sit by and let this pass you or let AI happen to you. The opportunity you have is to really lead your company to a competitive advantage by harnessing this powerful fundamental inflection point that we're on. And you have to assume that your competitors are doing the same. So while this is a daunting task that you have to wrap your arms around, you don't have to go alone, right? That's where companies like AMD come in as your trusted advisors and partners in this space.
Yes, absolutely. And how important, Rahul, is it for IT leaders to be embedded across their organization? For example, to ensure new technology really does drive higher productivity?
Yeah, I think that's a very good question, Vic. I mean, if you think about it, right, is CIOs are not about just deploying technology or deploying IT. They have to have a very deep understanding of the company and how the various organizations are working and how they do business. What are their key KPIs and goals? How do they plan to accomplish that? What are the strategic imperatives they have as an organization? How do they do the work that they do? What processes do they follow? What tools do they need? What are the challenges that they have on a day-to-day basis? This level of a deep understanding of the various organizations that form the enterprise is super important for CIOs. When you think about larger companies, AMD being no different, by the way, we have thousands, tens of thousands of employees. Every organization has different needs. This can result in thousands of use cases. The art of being an IT leader or CIO is being able to sort of find this common thread, or what I like to call personas, across these various use cases, and, you know, sort of make IT solution decisions that solve for this common set of personas. And to be able to do this, CIOs have to have a very intimate understanding of the business.
Yeah, a really interesting way of kind of encapsulating how they've got to understand a business right across a whole range of different areas. Do you have examples, perhaps within AMD or the clients you work with, that highlights how these changes are impacting?
Yeah, so if you think about AMD, you know, our CIO, Hasmukh Ranjan, has implemented a three-pronged sort of AI strategy, and you know, he's evaluating, and that team has evaluated AMD's needs from all of these angles so that we can drive a significant adoption of AI solutions within our corporation. So looking at it tops-down first, where you're really looking at the business needs based on high-level use cases and their impacts at the C-suite level, and then doing a bottoms-up assessment of all of the user needs they improve, that, you know, the productivity improvements they need based on surveys and direct requests from users. And oh, by the way, many users in your corporation are probably running skunkworks projects with AI already, right? So you need to take stock of that. And then, you know, measuring and quantifying all of these different use cases and all of the skunkworks projects that are going on to sort of figure out what are the most important projects or use cases that will drive long-term business outcomes for your enterprise. And that's the approach that we have taken, right? And with that approach and with a comprehensive data strategy that underlines that approach, meaning, you know, having the method to securely train models and implement you know, enterprise level AI stacks, and all of this has driven the right adoption of AI within AMD, and ensuring that the AI initiatives that we're driving are aligned to the top level goals that we have as a business.
Yeah, I think that alignment is key, and is something that a lot of CIOs are thinking about. But I just wonder, Raul, can CIOs sort of afford to hold back and just see what happens with regards to this transformation that we're seeing take place? Our latest data shows that 60% of organizations are reporting that they have not got past the research and pilot phase of AI. Now, I guess the big question here is, do they need to accelerate?
Yeah, I think the short answer is yes. They need to absolutely accelerate. You know, there's a spectrum of how CIOs are approaching AI today. Those that want to wait for AI to mature and deploy at scale, you know, more of a wait and see approach. And there's others that are jumping in the deep end and navigating the challenge real time. My personal opinion is that you want to be the one jumping into the deep end. While it's a very difficult and hard sort of problem, you can't be left behind. You can't be sitting on the sidelines. This world is changing implicitly every day. There's new use cases. There's new large language models, large data center deployments. You know, you have to sort of jump in and learn. And so if you're really on the side of that jumping in the deep end, you need partners. You need people who have done this before. You won't be an expert in everything. And you should not be, right? And so bring your business goals and outcomes and marry that with AMD's technology prowess and the knowledge we have in deploying AI at scale, and we can be your trusted partners, right? So that's the way to think about this problem is jump in now, accelerate, don't be left behind. It's a business imperative. Companies will win or lose based on the AI wars that are going on, and we're here to help you.
Yeah, there's no doubt that AI is going to be a defining factor in that business competition you speak of. And it's critical that IT leaders can speak the language of the C-suite, who are more focused on business results than perhaps the complexities of technology itself. Now, can AMD help with that particular challenge?
Yeah, absolutely. In our engagements with CIOs to date, we've supported them to navigate, you know, translation of our technology into business outcomes for them and the C-suite. Many CIOs and IT organizations are measured on employee NPS. You know, how happy our employees, how engaged they are is driven by the employee NPS. And at the heart of it is better IT experience, better devices, you know, that drives more satisfied employees. We've engaged in collaborative conversations where we've asked, what is it that you need? And what we've heard is, you know, I understand, but we have fixed budgets. Help me justify some of these investments to the board. And so, you know, they're struggling with how to come up with the right TCO models. What's the ROI on the investments? What's the business outcomes that it's going to lead to? And so we can help you determine, you know, the costs that are involved in large scale AI deployments. And then what kind of efficiency are they going to drive? What kind of performance are they going to drive in productivity in the enterprise employee base is going to drive for you? And we've worked with many partners and leaders in the industry to help quantify, you know, your IT strategy into business metrics. You know, one more thing I want to add. Look, I come from the PC end of the business, like I started, right? I would say, you know, when you think about AI PCs as an example, right, it's a small element of the overall IT strategy. AI PCs are not just a simple upgrade or a simple generational change. You know, okay, I'm going to refresh from my 3-year-old, 5-year-old PCs to the new AI PCs. I think they're a necessity, they're an important tool that allows businesses to stay competitive in this AI race that we have. Enabling employees to have much better experience with their machines. And so we can help you understand, I can help you understand how AI PCs can fit into that sort of, you know, strategy of broader AI deployment for your organizations.
Yeah, and that is absolutely key for CIOs, I'm sure. And can AMD also help CIOs develop a strategic and transformative vision for their businesses, which is obviously a critical task?
Yeah. Absolutely. I think we've worked with many large corporations, many enterprises, and we understand, at least what a large-scale AI deployment looks like from cloud to data center to, you know, the networking needs and the data center GPU needs and server compute needs all the way into endpoint compute through our client devices, right? We're a powerhouse in this area. So let's collaborate. You know, you bring in the business outcomes you're looking for and what strategic outcomes you're looking for as a corporation, and let us help you be successful.
As we come towards the end of this discussion, Rahul, what final sort of takeaways, what final points would you like to leave our audience with?
Yeah, I think I'll just sort of summarize the conversation we had. Look, AI, we all know, is a huge transformative step. It's sort of like, you know, the new electricity, you know, the new oil. We have found this new thing that is going to drive immense progress, immense human progress. It's going to have very, very foundational transformative impacts on your business, right? Businesses will, there'll be many trillion dollar companies that will be formed as a part of AI. You cannot just wait at the sidelines. And I'm sure you're not waiting on the sidelines to figure out what to do. Now, it can be daunting. There's a big task. You have fixed budgets. There's competing priorities. Let us help you navigate that, right? We can be a key partner. We've done this with many corporations, cloud to client. We're able to help you navigate the TCO, the ROI, work with your board, understand how to drive the investment strategy around this, what outcomes it drives for you, and help you win and transform in the AI era. So those are sort of the summarization of the conversation we just had.
Yes, thank you, Rahul. It's been great speaking with you. That does indeed bring us to the end of this CIO webcast with AMD on how CIOs can ensure they are leading digital transformation efforts in the AI age. I'd like to thank Rahul for sharing his expert insight as well as everyone who watched. Goodbye.